Very good afternoon, everyone. Well, definitely the best part about the conferences are the networking breaks. And it's exciting to see the energy all the attendees are having. So, moving on to our next session on rooftops and distributed solar. Rooftops definitely has been quite low on the installation side in India till now, as opposed to developed nations or the leading nations of the world like Germany, US, Japan, where rooftop solar has much larger share as compared to utility scale. And as the situation in the power sector goes today, where we're seeing power surplus because of lack in efficiency of distribution channels and the power prices going up, which obviously is very difficult for commercial industrial entities to absorb. And so rooftops makes definitely a great business sense. And the fire is slowly catching up. Times to come, solar energy roof on your rooftops with electric vehicles and energy storage. The demand per entity, or of any, if you talk about households or any commercial entity or industrial entity, the demand per unit of these entities will definitely dramatically go up, which will make a lot of rooftops happen, and definitely energy storage will give a lot more sense to rooftops in times to come. Having said that, already we've seen some markets like Mumbai and all where storage already makes a lot of sense. So I'm happy that we have a panel which is having a lot of experience into rooftop solar, and who are like professionals and companies who are number one or leading companies in the distributed solar space. So may I take this pleasure and honor and opportunity to invite our session chair, Mr. Anuvrat Joshi, Director, Cleantech Solar, on the stage. Rupam Gautam, Head Sales North India for fourth partner. Mr. Gambhir Balyan, Head of Operations for Everest Solar. Ritulal, Vice President Business Development at Amplus. Our special guest, Mr. Shekhar, Director General, Solar Power Developers Association. We'll have Mr. Shri Prakash Rai replacing Mr. Pena, AMP Solar. May I request everyone from the networking zones to kindly settle down so that we can begin our session on rooftops. In recent times, we have seen big markets like China who were not doing so much in rooftops, and suddenly they have realized that rooftops is the way to go forward. So I'm sure so will be the case with India. And there are great innovative business models put in place by leading companies. Good thing about rooftops, we will see lots and lots of entrepreneurial activity, so which makes it all the more highly exciting. So ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome our distinguished panelists with a big round of applause. May I request our session chair, Mr. Anuvrat Joshi, to please take over and begin with this session. Thank you.
Thank you, Anand, and thank you for having all of us over, giving us one more opportunity to talk to the audience and the industry about about rooftop solar. It's an area that, you know, some of us have kind of made our bread and butter and focused on. The segment is easily over 3 years old now. Some of us, you know, in fact, have been doing projects for a lot longer than that. And if you can consider it on a CapEx basis, perhaps, you know, the sector has been around for over 5 years. And I'm talking about in a meaningful, commercial, sizable way. You know, without adding too much from my end, I just wanted to suggest, like, you know, quickly the format and then, you know, do the introductions. First, we will just, you know, give every each one of the panelists a couple of minutes to introduce themselves, their company, you know, and what their company does or what their organization does. And then we will come to some of the questions. We will tend to reserve the question, your questions, for later. If you have a burning question, let us know. We will see if that's the right moment to, you know, that's the right moment to sort of take it on. One small announcement, you know, we're a little bit late starting. Mr. Shekhar Dutt has to leave a little early, so just wanted to mention that he might be not with us for the whole session. So with that, I think we request the panelists to introduce themselves. Sir, can we start with you?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's a privilege to be sitting over here after lunch when I think everyone would be expecting music, but unfortunately, there are other business to do. I represent Solar Power Developers Association. Almost all of our members are ground-mounted solar, large solar projects. However, I was there in COP21 when Honorable Prime Minister gave this target of 40,000 megawatts to be generated from rooftop solar. And everybody was very sanguine about that. India's got such a large real estate business and growing business and huge development of new cities, that this is a very appropriate thing which the Prime Minister has put. I'm sure that many people would have thought that it's easy and perhaps we'll just smoothly sail into this. But since COP21 has happened, we already crossed a year, and our rooftop capacity is somewhere around, maybe less, maybe around 2 gigawatts. We have to travel a long distance, but it's not something which is not doable. And I'm absolutely sure that given a few sort of thing which we have to do ourselves, if those steps are done, then rooftop becomes far more easier because there's a demand. And there's a tremendous demand, distributed demand, which is available. And mind you, and we got the world's largest diesel generating capacities. More than 90,000 megawatts worth of diesel generating sets are on service. And there are many of them which are off service, which are often on use, make our diesel generating capacity over 100,000 megawatts. These are the things which can be replaced by rooftop. As far as the older roofs are concerned, or wherever the diesel generating sets are being used. But the newer capacities could be created in the cities, the smart cities. There are already work going on for more than, say, creating more than 100 smart cities. A few state capitals require, you know, I was in Chhattisgarh, and almost the entire new Raipur can have more solar rooftop solar. Similarly, Amravati or the Andhra Pradesh capital is being sort of planned. And if entrepreneurs with a little foresight and perhaps willing to take up challenges, go and talk, we would have roofs designed for maximum solar power development. Now, how do we do that? I asked a number of people, what is their discussion with, say, architects or a big builder? In fact, I went over to one major company of energy producing company. And when I came down into the lobby, the same building, I found at least 6 or 7 major hoardings of new townships or beautiful townships all around in Bombay. So I asked the gentleman, who was a general manager of that company, accompanying me, and I asked him, do you notice anything strange in these hoardings? So he looked at, because every day he looks while he comes in his own office and climbs up the lift, a few floors, he notices that. So I said that, do you notice anything strange? So it took a lot of goading, but he didn't. Then I said, have any builders written that whether they are going to use RE? He said, oh, no. I said, you deal with RE and you couldn't influence them. Now, what I'm saying is that as far as the people who buy floors or buy houses, for them it would be a good thing that, oh, in this particular block we will have complete RE. Now for that you require discussion with the architect. How would the roof be designed? What would be the inclination? How would the space be organized? Now all these things, ladies and gentlemen, are within our control. And we ought to do that. If we don't do that, it's going to be a dream achieving 40,000 megawatts. Another thing, side by side, we should be also thinking of the enormous potential of grid solutions. India is full of agriculture and people eking out their livelihood from agriculture. If their plots or the farmland is very near a major city, then they can produce goods or agriculture produce and bring it to the market at least cost. But if it is anything more than 150 to 200 kilometers away, then the cost of transportation becomes very high, and therefore it is of no surprise that a large number of farmers actually have to end their lives because they can't pay back the loan. So what do we do? At the same time, we've got a surplus farm produce. Much of it gets rotted. So can we do food processing? Can this food processing be consumed within the country and consumed outside the country? I remember about 20 years ago, or maybe what, 1990, yeah, almost 30 years ago, Pepsi came and it revolutionized Punjab agriculture. And they gave not only good seeds, and they had contracts with the farmer so that they'll buy the produce. Now, it's a very simple thing what they did. They just took the farmer and said that we're going to give you good seeds for potato or for some other things, and we will buy the crop if it is within this standard, and we give you the money. And farmers got good money and immediate payment. Pepsi didn't think of using solar plants, but this can be thought now. all these off-grid places, and somebody in the previous session said that how Punjab thermal are being used at 40% of their capacity, and that also at much higher rates of production. So we can have the farmers gaining, as well as a good market available for Indians to have good quality of processed farm food. Similarly, I mean, many people would have seen or heard of the Masdar town, which they have made, and I was amazed that I don't remember how many, maybe 1,000 houses, each costing $1 million. $1 million in our this thing would be how much? $1.1 million. Would be about 6-7 crores. Seven crores. Now this is exactly the amount. This is a 4,000 square feet house, and they sold these houses. They made this township. Now, in this township, every house has a rooftop solar. The car park have rooftop solar. I mean, the car parking has solar roofs, and every car is electric driven. Now, the beauty of this thing is that people have bought these houses a couple of years ago, moved in, and now they have started earning money through the surplus energy which is then generated in this Masdar town in Dubai, because it goes back into the grid, the surplus. We've got, I mean, Haryana state in which I live has certainly this arrangement that we have net metering, and if you produce separate, perhaps the you can earn a little money. Now, if the townships are built, big houses, I've been moving around, and I stay in some hotels, and every time I take a morning walk, and I prefer those hotels which have a compound where you can do a morning walk, and I find all their these walkways are littered with diesel generating set. I don't know whether this hotel has rooftop solar. Now, we have to talk. People have to talk and get these big construction, whether they're the colleges, schools, or any big housing projects, to have rooftop. And the architects will have to sit down and design the roof in such a manner that we have. I think it is within our capacities. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Hi everyone. I'm Saurav. I am representing a firm called Rely on Solar. It's a Pune-based firm, and we are into solar EPC. Our company is in this solar sector for the last 7 years, and we currently have an installed capacity of around 60 plus megawatt all over India. My point is, I mean, I have been listening to various opinions since morning. My point is, had this conference been taking place 5 years or 6 years ago, we would have been talking whether to go solar or not. Today we are talking how. So today I see that the savings for a customer, a person who is using solar power, is comparatively more when he is actually installing a project in the CapEx model. I mean, for example, if you have a 200 kilowatt installation, rooftop installation, you get the whole investment back within 4 to 5 years. And once you get the payback of your investment, the solar power that you consume out of that solar plant is at around 1.2 rupees per unit. For the lump sum that much, continued up to, let's say, 25 years. Same when you are doing it in the OPEX model, your comparatively savings would be a little lesser. But still, people preferred the OPEX model because they thought, okay, our funds can be used, better used elsewhere, or we are skeptical about this technology. Today, this trust factor has come into this solar industry. People are trusting the technology ki haan, jitna generation the EPC person is quoting is actually possible to get, and it's a reliable technology. So I want to talk about another thing, which is there are few things which enable this thing to happen. One is it's one of our products actually. It's called SolGrid. So essentially, as Dutt sir said, that India has a lot, a big capacity of diesel generators installed everywhere in commercial, residential, and industrial establishments. So SolGrid is a product which was developed as a DG synchronizer, because as we know, if we have a solar plant operating with a diesel generator, you may end up damaging the diesel generator if excess power goes into the diesel generator. Also, there were initially complications where there was a net metering, and even today, when you install a solar power plant, you have got it commissioned, you are able to evacuate power out of it. There can be cases where it's taking 1 or 2 months extra to get the net metering done at your location. So you cannot and the problem is the current, the normal energy meters that we have, they are one-way meters, and if you are not able to consume whole of your solar power, then it will read extra and you will have to pay extra bills because of having a solar power plant at your location. So SolGrid was also able to contain that, and we had a reverse power control installed at different clients. So these are few things that helped us gain trust from our customers, and today we see that 30% of our current customers are actually repeat customers, repeat businesses. Another thing is now about generation. In the morning first session, Ms. Tania, she said about the importance of more generation out of your current establishment. So solar trackers for ground mount systems is a phenomenal way to increase your generation. We have also developed our own solar tracker system, which is able to give 18 to 25% more energy at the cost of around 12% more. So it benefits both the developer as well as the client at the end of the day, because the developer is able to earn more and able to produce power at lesser costs and provide it to the client, and also the client is getting more renewable energy out of it. So these are a few things that we need to invest on, and not only invest money in, but invest significant amount of workforce to develop. This morning we had a presentation regarding another single axis tracker, which was a very nice idea, and more such efforts need to come up in our industry by everyone who are presently in the industry for significant amount of time. Solar is understood to be a very modular technology, but difference can be made by investing in different products such as SolGrid and single axis tracker that we have done. So I think this is something which I wanted to share with everyone. Thank you.
Okay. No, thank you. Thank you, Saurav. And I'm glad that, you know, as opposed to the original agenda, we now have a EPC person on the panel, because that's always valuable, you know. So you have your developers here and RESCOs, as you will get introduced. You have somebody who's sort of seen the every side of the government in Mr. Shekhar Dutt. But, you know, it's good to have an EPC person on the panel.